going? I'm Randall, this is JJ, PravaGotTraining.com. In this video, we're going to go over the sit-up and sweep, and we're going to focus on the proper positioning with your arms. There's a lot of little details with the arms that students neglect. I want to address those in this particular video. So, we're going to start off in close guard. The best time to hit up the sit-up and sweep is anytime your partner or bad guy is sitting back. If I see their butt close to their heels, they're leaning really far back. They'll do this a lot so they have a lot of space to either prevent you from clinching with them or so they can hit you really hard. But if I see this, this is a great time to do the sit-up and sweep. So first thing I need to do is uncross my ankles and sit up and roll up to my elbow and my forearm. But here's a common mistake that I see is that students will stay on their forearm and elbow. The problem is you can't secure the grip over here very well. You can't drive your hips up very hard. So it's okay to initially get up on your elbow and forearm, but once you do that, then you need to transition to your hands and straighten out your arm. Because when I straighten out my arm, now I can push off with this leg, and rise my hips up very, very high. The key to the sit-up and sweep, that what makes it work, is your hips. It's your hips driving into the person. And you will not be able to maximize that power if you do not post up on your hand and straighten out your arm. So don't make a mistake of staying on your form. Yeah, there are times and places where you can do this, especially if he's a little bit lower, I can sweep him. But in general, the sit-up and sweep is straight arm. So once you roll up, okay to start on your elbow and forearm, and then transition to your hand. Now I'm going to focus on the other arm detail here. Make sure that you push with this hand and your 2 feet and rise your hips up really high. The higher you rise your hips up, the better. Not only because I can do the sweep stronger and drive my hips really hard, but it makes this particular grip a lot easier. And there's some important details to what I do with this arm. A lot of people kind of half-ass this part, but this part's important as well. First thing is I want my armpit on the top of his shoulder area like this. I don't want to be low like this. I want like this. And then from here, my hand's going to cup the tricep above the elbow, or if you have a long sleeve shirt or jacket, I can hold on to that. But the general area is the same, either gripping clothing or cupping here. Now here's another detail is, I don't like the arm waving out here like this because if I sweep him, he can stick that hand out and balance and prevent the sweep. Granted, I can transition into other submission holds, but if I want a clean sweep, what I want to do is take this arm and hug it in tight to my torso and this elbow and clamp down hard, this downward pressure, onto his torso. When I do this, pull this in tight, clamp down with my elbow really strong, it's a lot more difficult for him to post that arm out because he can't stick that arm out for balance. He might be able to stick it out here. I can still power through that sweep. Now, he needs his hand posted out way over here off to the side like this to stop the sweep. The more this hand goes in here, the less he's going to be able to stop that sweep. So to prevent him from posting his hand out far to the side, cup the tricep, hugging him tight to your body, and clamp that elbow down hard. And then from here, finish the sweep. So those are all the little details of the arms. Very, very important details. So remember, roll up. It's okay to get on your elbow, but don't stay there. Post up on your hand, push with your feet, rise your hips up high. Now it's going to make this particular grip a lot easier. Armpit over the top of the shoulder, cup at the tricep just above the elbow where you can grab the material if it's available, and don't forget to hook it tight. When I'm sweeping in really hard, I also pull up this part at the same time. This elbow clamp is doing really strong. Once I do all these things, my actual hip movement would be a lot stronger, the sweep would be stronger, and you won't be able to post that arm out now in a dominant position and continue fighting. So those are all the little details with your arms, both the arm that you post on, as well as the arm that you use to grip to secure that hold so you can sweep them so they can't post their hand out. So focus on those details, and if you do that, and also time properly where you get your partner sitting back, that's the best time to do the sweep. Don't try to do the sweep unless they're really sitting back. If you focus on those details and the